Hi and welcome
to Moovz.com.
Yes. hi and welcome. We're here on Moovz.com and we are here with the precious, amazing, beautiful, wonderful, talented Rose Fostanes, who's the winner of the first edition of the Israeli X Factor.
Don't say beautiful.
Why? You are, but you are. That's, people now think that you're beautiful. That's the good thing about you. You know, that's the thing that happens when somebody wins something as big as the X Factor. People really, he's suddenly beautiful to them. This is the nice thing about life.
Ah, yeah. But another beautiful, I thought that...
That what? What?
Nothing, because I don't consider myself as beautiful.
But now beautiful. We have to convince you that you're beautiful, Rose. So maybe we use this show as a therapy thing to convince you that you're beautiful, okay? Okay, so my first question is, but before I convince you that you're beautiful, tell me how do you feel after winning? Like we are a month after winning, it was a month ago, and?
Wow, it's crazy now. I think everybody, before it was 10%, that
yes.
Grab me on the street and jump on me. Now everybody jump on me.
Okay, and you're strong, so you can hold them.
Yeah, I can catch all of them. I can catch them because I have, no, really, they are so happy that I won, and they are, all of them are saying that I deserve to win. And, but I think it's a little bit hard because it's like I don't have privacy now.
Yes.
But it's okay.
So when you want to go out and have a coffee in the Tachana Merkazit, you...
No, just like that. I cannot go to a place, especially in Tachana Merkazit, that before, every time after my work, I'm going there and sit and talking with my friends. But
yeah.
Now, it's very hard for me. I can sit, but the problem is...
Maybe you should do this. Go like this, you know? Like,
no,
like have this little manifest.
No, this is the funny thing also. Even... I'm looking, I was walking behind me,
yes.
And everybody, they don't see my face and they see me behind,
and they recognize.
They can recognize me. This, I don't know, maybe because of my shape, huh?
Yes, it's because, because you're very specific.
Yeah, and even I am hiding like this and they can see me.
Yes.
Rose, is that you?
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm denying, you know, saying, no, it's not me, but no, it's you.
It's a good thing to say, are you Rose? No. I'm just another Filipino woman. What do you want?
It's crazy, really, but I love it.
What was the best moment of the competition? Except for winning, of course.
The best moment is when we are together and eating together and exchanging jokes.
But behind the scenes.
Yeah, behind the scenes.
Yes. And were all the judges nice to you?
Yeah, they were all nice.
Who was the nicest? Except for Shiri. Shiri was your mentor. But
I think everybody.
Yes.
Every leader and
Moshe Peretz.
They're all nice, and also
Rami Fortis.
They're all nice to me.
Yes. And what did you talk to them about?
They are saying that I'm a good singer, and I really went after the competition. They told me that I deserve to win. And also Ivri leader, I love her. I
yes.
love him so much.
Yes. He's very nice. He's my best friend, you know?
Yeah, I like him. You know, that sometimes they're saying that how he judge and he's telling me like this. He's right.
Yes.
He's right. All what he's saying is it's good.
Okay.
Not because...
No, I know, because you feel like this. It's okay.
No, really, I like him.
Good.
So now I'm going to introduce you to Yona Patriot. She is really famous drag queen in Israel.
Yo,
I'd like to say thank you for inviting me here, and also thank you to Moovz.com. It's a new social networking for gays.
So tall.
a small matana for you.
Wow. Pink
salted
egg.
Egg. Salted egg. Where you belong. In the corner of my bar. With my heels. Sit back down on a couch where we made love the first time. And you say to me. So. Something about this place.
I will show how the Filipino drink coffee together with the bread.
Okay.
You take this kaka.
Kaka.
You cut very angry like this if it's hard. And you will dip very deep.
Dip in the coffee.
And after that, you will open your mouth.
Swallow.
And then after.
To try.
With your egg.
Like this.
With your egg.
Dip in the coffee. And then.
Open your mouth and.
Actually, it's good. And Jesus Christ, something about this life. I'm from LA and she's number one on camera.
She is my favorite.
Thank you.
From EPRS, we would like to say congratulations because for us you are already a winner, number one. We love you, Rose.
Good luck to you. Filipinim are always proud of you and we believe in you.
Hello, Ate Osang. I just want to congratulate you and we are proud to you.
Hi, Rose. Congratulations. Masalto, Batslaka, we support you. I'm Virgie from the Filipino community.
Hi, Rose. This is Ruby from Pinay Namaste. Good luck for your show today.
Hi, Osang. Mazal tov. We are with you in this venture.
Hey, Rose. It's John. I just wanted to say congratulations. I'm really happy you have all my support, especially from the Filipino community. And congratulations.
All Filipino community here in Israel, they're supporting you.
Hello, Rose. This is the WIC family. We support you. We love you. Good luck. For tonight, for X Factor, Masalto!
We love you.
God bless.
Masalto.
May you win the X Factor and you will be the X Factor Israel, the first winner.
Moovz family are supporting you for the final in the X Factor Israel. We sure you will be the best because you are, for us, you are already the big star ever.
Okay, joining us now is Idan Matalon. Idan Matalon did all these beautiful videos that you just saw. And he was with Rose during the days before she won the X Factor and after. And hello, Idan.
Hello, how are
so you?
So
you two know each other? Yeah, yes, you ate bread together. Yes, what's the thing about the bread?
Actually, it was very tasty. I like it. Yeah, I did it again and again after that. And now I'm teaching my friends to do the same. So, Filipino culture.
So tell me about what did you discover while doing these videos? What did you discover about the Filipino community in Israel?
Actually, this video we did a month before the final of X Factor, and we didn't know that she gonna win. It was like very fresh everything, and I just realized that people all the time stop you in the streets, asking for picture. They said, "Oh my God, Rose, we love you, we love you, we love you."
Yes, I think I'm still in the final.
But you were famous from the moment from your first audition. You know, when you went on stage for the first time and you sang, everybody fell in love with you. And that was it.
That's what I saw. They were really empty. And we've been in the drag queen show.
The drag queens, they're very tall. Yeah, the problem with drag queens, they're always very tall. I don't like drag queens to stand next to drag queens because they're very tall.
They are tall already and they are still wearing the high heels. Yes. So they become more tall.
More tall.
Like giant.
That was your first time in a drag show?
Yeah, it was my first time.
In Evita or in a drag show?
In a drag show.
In a drag show.
Yeah.
And in Evita also.
In Evita, I think I went there twice. But
before?
Yeah, it was, but it's my first time that I would be with drag queen.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
you know, because I'm all the time doing the sponge and don't have time to meet people's like yeah. you and Idan, you know.
Okay.
It's the first time.
Okay, so now you don't do sponge anymore. No sponge for you anymore, Rose. That's over.
Actually, it was, for me, it was a great experience because a day after she won, we've been in the karaoke bar of the Philippines near the Tachana Merkazit. And it was amazing. I felt like I'm in Manila.
Okay.
In the Philippines, and everyone was so happy that she won.
Yes.
And we did an interview with a morning show in the Philippines. We broadcast an interview by Skype, remember?
Yeah, yeah.
It was so nice.
And now you are working together on Moovz. So yeah, now you are it.
Thank you to Moovz.com.
Thank you to Moovz.
Thank you to Moovz.
I have to ask you, are all the Philippines so modest, or it's just you? Because I've met people who won competitions like X Factor or Kochav Nolad, and they're always, they say, yes, I'm so thankful, but they're not really so thankful. They always think that they deserve it. And you really are thankful for it. It's a strange thing, Rose.
And really, because what I feel, this is what I'm saying. All what I it's with me in my heart. This is coming out from my mouth.
Yes, but you were always like sure about your singing. You knew that you were a good singer, that you had a good voice, and that you have like an inner passion to sing.
But yeah, they said, but I don't feel that really I'm a good singer if I don't ask this to anybody. Uh-huh. Because people be the one who will judge really if I sing good. I cannot say it by myself that I'm a good singer. No, I don't. I'm asking everybody, really, is it nice? I'm a good singer. If they say yes, especially the Israeli people, because I know that they are straight.
Yes.
They can say really if it's no or yes. So if they say
just
yes,
rude.
I believe.
It's not that they are straight, they are rude.
Rude.
Yes, they are
but
like.
What do you need to ask them? I mean, you have almost 1 million views on YouTube. It's like, it's wow. You know?
Yeah, I was surprised also when I saw the last piece that I sang.
Yeah.
It was My Way. In 1 month, it's already 1 million. Only in 1 month.
Million
times. Million views.
You understand it? Million people
watch your video.
Yeah, and I was
that's
really...
That's a lot. That's a lot, Rose. Let's watch. We have some other clips we want to show you. Let's watch them.
Hello!
Hello!
How are you? Hey,
Israel at sa Pilipinas. Maraming salamat po. At maraming salamat din po sa X Factor nang dahil po sa kanila eh nakarating po yung aking mahal na kapatid at ang aking partner. Ayan, maraming na si Mel. Okay, and maraming salamat sa pagsuporta ng Moovz.com.
Here we go! Miss Rose, Osang, Fostanes! Here
comes the gold! So now look, everybody in Israel will said a million tzfiot. You know the word tzfiot, yes? Now?
Views.
Tzfiot. Okay. No, so now we have questions for you. People ask questions, and we want to ask you to show you the questions, and you will answer. It's very simple.
Okay.
Okay. The first question is...
Hi, my name is Maya, and I'm the face of two lesbian bands called Less Is More and All Stars. Congrats, Rose. You're amazing. I'm a big fan, and I wish I could sing like you. Tell me, what's your secret to having such a huge voice?
What's your secret?
I think there's no secret. Besides, I have how you call that a show. I don't make any rehearsal at home.
Yeah.
No, I'm not doing that. Maybe because I was born singing.
Yes.
Maybe.
No, but the question is. But I know a lot of people. When they have, even if they have a good voice, if they don't practice every day and they don't sing professionally, the voice somehow becomes smaller and not so nice. And with you, it's a miracle that because you haven't been singing professionally during the years. But have you been singing all the time?
Did you study or something?
No, I didn't. I don't have even a professional trainer because we don't have money to
No, but you, for example, in the last years when you were doing working, how many times a week would you sing to yourself or?
Because I was singing in a small karaoke every time during my day off, so maybe I get practice on that.
Just like once a week in the karaoke, and that's it.
Yeah, that's it. And every time if I have a, if I'm performing to a show, for me one glass of tea and water it's enough. That's it. Before I sing.
Okay, here is the next. Yes, let's go to the next question.
This is Karen Dutan, and I'm the owner of 3 lesbian friends, All Star, Less Is More, and Be Proud. First of all, congrats for winning the X Factor. I really hope you can come to my event sometime. My question is, among the candidates, who are you most close with?
In X Factor, I think I am more close to my category, Abhishakar.
Abhishakar?
Yeah.
So did you meet him after the show?
No, but because we don't have contact numbers and like this. But I like all of them. But most of the time I was talking to Abhishakar. And because...
Did you meet his family?
Yeah,
his I met... mothers and...
No, only her sister and brother when I was in the show.
Okay.
He's a very nice person, you know. Yes. I like him.
Yes. And are you still in touch with Shiri? Have you spoken to Shiri in the last...
Yeah, Shiri, she spoke to me a week ago and she told me that if we have time together, we will meet to drink coffee outside. And she told me that we will discuss about the concert that...
She will host you, right?
Yeah, that she will make on this coming March, I think. Because she told me that she's going to take me with her dad to be a guest.
Yes, perform in Hala Tarbut. It's very, very prestigious. It's like our biggest... most famous hall. And what will you sing there, you know?
No, we don't talk about this yet, but she told me that she's going to take me. Maybe I will sing one song with her. And I'm very excited for that.
Okay, and do you know her songs? Did you know her songs before the show?
Yeah, I heard about her that she also won in a competition like this.
Yes.
And but she didn't get the grand
second.
She was second.
But she became very famous. And
but did you know her songs? No.
I know only her song, like the one that we did in X Factor, but in English.
Ah, okay.
You know, I heard some of her videos, like she sang the Beatles, and I saw her also in the Eurovision.
Yes.
She also
number 4.
Yeah.
Yes, she came number 4. She was a good... Okay, next question.
My name is Joe Mirbal. I'm a fashion journalist. First of all, I'd like to congratulate you on winning the first ever Israeli X Factor. I'm sure you're very excited. You were amazing on the show. I was wondering about your makeover process on the show. They gave you an asymmetrical hairstyle and put you mostly in black gowns during the competition. How involved were you in all of this? Did you have a say on the matter, or did you just let the stylists and producers work their magic? And lastly, how do you see yourself dressing for concerts in the future? Are you going to use a stylist's help, or just pick it yourself? I'd love to sit down and talk more about all of this. Be sure to catch my TV show Style, where I give fashion advice for other Israeli celebrities. Thank you.
Before you answer the very, very special questions by Joe from Chatzot HaBidur, from Moovz Entertainment. We have a new guest here, Nona Chalant. She will. She brought some jewelry for you, so that when we talk about your style, we can do some things and maybe change your style, or help you with your style, or just learn from your style. Yes? You think it's nice for me?
Yes. This is your look.
Yes, you see? Because I'm a Yemenite. I'm from Yemen. Yes.
So you need to put clothes for belly. So.
So do you want to say anything about Rose's style?
Let's talk about your style, like Joe asked.
Yes.
So in the X Factor, you wear a lot of black gowns.
Yeah.
Is it something you wanted?
No, because I like also black colors, because black colors makes me thin, you know.
Yes.
You know me that I'm very sexy. Everybody knows that.
You are a very sexy woman.
But I love the extra large factor.
And it's very hard for me to find clothes because I'm sexy, like what I told you.
Because good delicious.
That's why it's very hard for me to find clothes. So I think black.
But now you need to demand from your record company a personal stylist that will find you the clothes, so you don't have to go and find them yourself.
I think yes, and I think I will give them very hard work, you know, really.
Okay.
If it'll be your stylist, Bar Fairly will be jealous.
Ah, really? Wow.
This is a pelican or something, yes? Yeah. Maybe like this?
What is this? Yeah. Is earrings?
This is
no, this is not earrings. This is like, I think it's like...
This is a necklace.
Ah. A necklace. But do you don't you like necklaces, also,
yeah? Yeah, because you know, I can, I have, I can wear this for, I think, 30 minutes and after it will... have a mark on my
yes. Okay.
That's why
so,
you can see me on
Moovz,
the...
Moovz, she doesn't like necklaces. What else do you have for her?
So we have
maybe
earrings.
Maybe earrings?
Yeah, little earrings, color.
Yes. So you'll be like the Filipino
colorful
flower girl.
Of course.
Yes, and also...
And we have something more Chinese.
Ah, this is Chinese earrings?
Yeah.
Yes.
I think it's nice, yes?
Yeah.
Yeah. It makes you look taller.
But it's too heavy.
Yeah. No, but the thing is that I think that earrings that when they are long, they make you look longer, yes?
But and if you want to be really high, you can
yes, wear high wow heels.
That's no how you get
do,
really
do you
high
ever wear high heels?
I was wearing before high heel, but when I gained more sexy.
Yes. Yes.
This is sexy.
It's hard for me to wear high heels now because you know it's like you know, because we are getting old. I'm very old now, so...
You're not that old, Rose. You're very young. You're 26.
It starts not to have that...
You look like 26.
So it's because I'm very old, it starts not to have the arthritis and some, you know... That's why for me, it's like... it's very hard for me to wear heels. And I don't feel comfortable, you know? It's like I'm comfortable only with the flat shoes and like rubber shoes.
You know what you should do? Like in the finals when you had like the stairs and you were standing here and Barre Faili was standing next to you and suddenly you were at the
yeah
same height. This was very good.
She told me to not to go down.
Yes, of course.
This also maybe I'm giving her a hard time. Hello, Rose.
Was she nice? Was it nice with her?
Yeah, Barre Faili was so amazing person. She is very nice. I love her so much.
Good. Okay, so anything else?
So Rose, tell me about your makeup. Do you do your makeup?
Yeah, about my makeup. I'm doing it by myself if I'm going not very important places. But in X Factor, in the show, somebody is doing for me the makeup and I like it.
And you tell them how to do
no,
your makeup
no
or you,
no
are, you trust them?
Rose is
they
very
trust
trustworthy.
Them, you know?
She trusts people. Anyway. Nona,
yeah,
thank you very much.
Thank
Idan,
you.
Thank you very
thank
much.
You.
And we are now going to have another conversation, just the two of us, huh? So, you know, for me, it was amazing to see how open you were about your sexuality, about being a lesbian from the first moment, because a lot of people, when they come on television, they say, well, maybe I tell it later, maybe I don't tell. But for you, it was like, as if it was the most natural thing in the world.
Yeah, I don't need to hide my girlfriend and I don't want to hide my sexuality because after that, everybody will know it.
Yes.
So I want them to be surprised.
Yes.
And besides, I'm very proud to have a girlfriend for 31 years. So I'm very proud to say to everybody that I'm with her and I'm a gay.
But when was the first time that you said that you were gay? Like, to the people that you work with and to everybody?
Yeah.
When you came to Israel, for example?
When I came to the Israel, nobody knows that except my neighbor who helps me to be here in
okay
Israel. But after that, I'm telling this to my friends who is close to me only.
Okay.
I never tell it to anybody, even to my flatmates. They don't know that.
They don't know? Why?
Because I don't want that it will be...
An issue,
something like, because you know in Filipino, they are not like here in Israel that very open about
that. They're not very open. And did you tell your employer?
My employer, yeah, she knows.
And she was very
yeah
open about it?
She's very supportive to me, the first one, because she is also gay.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, she's a gay woman.
Yeah, she's also a lesbian.
Okay, so if you're telling people very slowly and everything, so how come that when you came to television, when it's the most open thing, you just said, okay, and I'm a lesbian, I have a girlfriend. It's the
yeah
one,
because
thing.
I know that it's a reality show, so
yes
whatever it happens, everybody will know my real life.
Yes.
So on the first day of the of my audition, there is a 3-hour interview.
Yes.
It's a part of audition.
Yeah.
Also, so this on that time I tell them that about my sexuality. And so I don't want to hide it because it will be open after.
It's amazing. It's amazing. And were they nice about it?
Yeah, you know, I think it's good that I tell this to all the people in Israel because I know that everybody here are very open.
Yes.
They don't care.
Yes.
Even you're a gay or lesbian or straight, they don't care about that. They have they are very supportive.
And now that you became famous, do people talk to you about this? The people that come to take photos or things, do they mention it every now and then?
Yeah, on the first on the first that it's shown on the
television?
On the newspaper that I'm a gay. So some of the Filipino in my Filipino community react about this, and they say that maybe it will affect on my singing career. But some of them, you know, understand. And not only in my Filipino community, also in Israeli, they say, like this, you know, we cannot please everybody. But after that, when they knew that I admit that I'm a gay, in the first, they get shocked and I receive some bad comments,
yeah.
Bad remarks. But after that, on the process, they become
supportive.
Yeah. They understand me.
Now, you've been with this woman, Mel, 31 years. It's a long time, Rose.
Yeah, really. Some of them don't believe that, wow, it's 31 years. Nobody can do that.
But isn't it very hard to live without her because you're far away from her?
Yeah, really. Because, you know, I will tell you, when I was 16 years old, we are together.
Yes.
So for me, I didn't experience to be a teenager because...
Because you were already as a teenager, you were in love with her.
Yeah. So when I decided to work abroad, and it's very hard for us to be separated, you know?
Yes.
I'm not with her all the times. But she understand.
Yes.
Before there is no cell phone, there is no
yes.
computer, just only letters. So
yeah.
we exchange letters. So that we can communicate to each other.
But now you can at least Skype and...
Yeah, now there is Skypes and we can talk every day, every minute, if we want to.
And how was it when she was here, when she came here?
Yeah, she was very happy and she can't believe that she will be here with me. Because it was 3 years ago when we see each other. But it's like there's a little bit problem now, you know? It's like
she's
I don't know, she is worried.
Why? That somebody will snap you and that you will fall in love with somebody else?
Yeah, this is what she think. Because when she saw my situation here, that I'm very busy and I gained a lot of friends. And she told me that you are now famous. So I'm scared that maybe I will lose you.
Oh.
That you will lose me. Something like this.
Oh, that's very sad.
Yeah.
But isn't she confident enough about your love that it will go?
For me, I think I will not change her. It's still the same.
Okay.
And maybe because I don't give her attention when she's here on the first week that she's here, I didn't give her any attention because
okay.
I was very, very busy, really.
Yes.
So this is the time that she was thinking, maybe you will not love me anymore and we will be...
Oh my God, I'm going to cry. It's very sad.
No, really?
Yes.
So she cried and we talked heart to heart and I tell her, you have to wait, we will see, because we don't know also that it will be like this.
Okay.
Because she keep waiting and waiting for me to be together, because you know I'm working abroad and I'm
yes,
leaving
she,
her all
and
the time.
And she's waiting all the time, you will come to the Philippines and live there just happily ever after, quietly?
Yeah, I was dreaming of that and she was dreaming that before.
Okay.
But when the X Factor came and I won the title, she get... She think, you know...
That everything will change now.
Yeah.
But everything will not change. Or will it?
For me, everything will not be changed. It's still the same.
You're still the same, Rose.
I'm still the
you
same.
You know that this is what every girl that wins the beauty pageant says, I'm still the same girl, and then they change totally.
This is also why she is so scared, because
yeah.
she heard something from the another, you know?
Anyway, Rose, I hope that you will stay together. and that you will be very happy. And it's such a pleasure to meet you. And I think you're a big inspiration for a lot of people and a lot of sectors in the world and in Israel. You know how it works. This whole show will not be completed without you singing to us something. I know it's not the best conditions, and you're now used to sing totally differently with a big band and everything. But can you sing for us just something little so you can hear your beautiful voice?
Okay, why not? Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I'm bit up more than I could chew. But true, in all, then who there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all and I stood tall and did it my way.
Bravo.
I think it's a little bit high.
It's your way. I'm so happy that we got to know you, and it's really amazing.
I'm very happy that I met you.
And I wish you all the best, and I want to kiss you. Oh,
thank you.
So, thank you. This is it. Thank you for watching us. Bye bye for
Moovz. Thank you to Moovz.com. We'll be right back.